I created an installation called Community at the Canada Gallery in the Toledo Museum of Art. When I visited Toledo on my first trip, I was really blown away by the museum and how it had connected to the community as an institution and the different groups that they already had within the community that were connected. And I proposed to Brian Kennedy, the director here, whether I could actually channel that into my artwork and key in, kind of use the community as they already were and bring it into my artwork. I really wanted to use what was growing in the land around Toledo and then plant it back into the land around Toledo. So as well as using my own collection of flowers that I had from over the last 10 years, we went to a local grower and had 1,000 trays of local plants that we took the heads of the flowers off and then used the root balls and planted them back into the gardens here at Toledo, and then the volunteers took them home to their own gardens. I was painting huge seascapes and paintings that were inspired by flowers, and I just decided that wasn't enough. And how could you physically experience nature? And how could you walk into a painting? So I was exploring all kinds of materials. I worked with plastic, food, wool, fabrics, sweets. And I was trying to use materials that were colorful, like I would with my paint, but in the 3D. And a lot of the experiments were really quite horrible. But finally, I was using flowers, and I could remember my parents drying flowers in the attic as a child. And I remembered they had a palette. Dry flowers had, from pink through to yellow and red, and you even have the creams and the more muted tones. So I felt like actually I could use that as a material to paint in the air with. And over the years, I've managed to find amazing flower growers and preservers of flowers. So the flowers that were here at Toledo were the best that I would say in the world in terms of preserved flowers and preserved color. So you could really experience walking into that piece and experience color as well as nature. The D install is actually very special now, and I treasure it, so every single line of flower is repackaged and boxed up with tissue and sent on to the next project. And the journey that the installation has been on, it won't stop here, it will be reused in a whole new installation somewhere else. And every single flower, I do know where it's been and where it's going next, and each one has a story and a journey. I think if I didn't archive the dust that I do have, I would be really sad. And for the brief moments that I've worked in floristry and things like that, where there is a lot of natural waste, I find it really hard. If anything was thrown in the bin, I would find it really difficult. But I think the fact that I treasure it, it's not so hard.